The movie Slumdog Millionaire is a raw depiction of the slums of India that follows the life of a slumdog through flashbacks of his hard-fought childhood up until real time in which he's entered in the show, Do You Want to Be a Millionaire? The film encapsulates India in an unprocessed manner that only does the storyline justice. In most movies I've seen that really stress the setting like this film does, the storyline gets lost or even becomes bland. It feels as if I'm watching a documentary because of how much of a new world I am in and how slow and drawn out the shots are to capture the setting. But in this film, I felt that every shot revolving around the setting was extremely necessary, as well as not drawn out and had a natural arrangement that allowed me to connect to the film unconsciously. This technique really coexisted with the film's narrative aspects. I felt this way because in most successful narrative films, they revolve around the main character and his or her journey to return the film's equilibrium, as it was lost in the beginning to give the film a purpose. That being said, you are always asking yourself, what is he/she going to do next? Because the film puts you in the main character's shoes. This feeling was only amplified for me in Slumdog Millionaire due to the filming and editing techniques to really depict life in the slums of India without making me feel out of place or otherworldly, while allowing me to get closer to the main character and follow his journey. Slumdog Millionaire's storyline connection to humanity also furthered these feelings and interpretations of mine because it was grounded in humanity and reality on Earth that Hollywood has gotten so used to overlooking. Most Hollywood films are catered to making the audience forget about reality, much like a Steven Spielberg film. And once the film is over, we realize we have to go back to our boring lives. But Slumdog Millionaire allowed me to dig deeper in internal struggles and real life that create a more moving feeling and a different perception at the end of the film rather than disappoint you that you have to go back to reality. I really enjoyed this film and how I was able to get such a realistic depiction of culture and lifestyle in India. The camera shots and editing were used to convey all of the aspects I have mentioned. For example, in the scene where Salim is pointing a gun at Jamal's forehead, the shot is over Salim's shoulder and the gun is in Jamal's face in the frame. This shot was very intense because the shot was in the viewpoint of Salim, where we could see what Salim was seeing, which was Jamal's heartbroken face. This shot gave the feeling of Salim had total power over Jamal and intensified the fact that Salim was betraying his brother because we knew that Salim was seeing the same thing as us, which was Jamal's petrified face. Then the camera cuts to an over-the-shoulder shot of Jamal now and the viewpoint of Jamal and the gun being pointed at his forehead while Jamal is looking at Salim. This shot was far more intense because now we get to see what Jamal is seeing, which is his brother looking merciless at him. These shots juxtaposed next to each other created a meaning that derived so many feelings from me. At first I felt, oh my god, Salim is crazy. And then when the shot changed to Jamal's viewpoint, I felt heartbroken and felt the betrayal even more so. Another scene I am going to discuss is the scene where Salim shot Maman in the brothel. In this scene, after Salim shot Maman, the camera cut to Jamal's face, which was shocked, and then cut to the perception of Jamal. And right after that, all the other shots were in slow motion and the sound was nearly gone. This signified we were in the viewpoint of Jamal, and he was so shaken up by what he just saw that his ears were ringing, he couldn't hear anything, and he couldn't process anything that was going on after Salim shot Maman. That's why everything was in slow motion. This was a very powerful scene because Jamal was watching Latika grab Maman's money and Salim yelling for them to get out of there, all in slow motion. Because Jamal couldn't even think or process what even happened, let alone think of grabbing the money and planning out where they were going to go, just like Latika and Jamal were. This scene really depicted how Jamal was feeling on the inside.